Alright, so in the last video, we created this abstract class complex base, and out of this abstract class, we created two concrete classes, right? This complex rectangular and this complex polar. So after doing all these things, we had this main function where we created one complex rectangular object and a complex polar object. Let me remove that C. Okay, complex base pointer C, and what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to add A and B. Okay, so this is A before addition, this is B, this is A after addition, and let me remove all these other things. Alright, so let me keep things simple. So I have two complex number, one is complex rectangular, another is complex polar, A and B respectively. Then A is 10 plus 20i, B is something in complex polar notation. And I add these two numbers and I print this number. Let me go ahead and compile and run this. So after compilation, this is what I'm going to get. A is 10 plus 20i, B is 20 plus 20i. And A after addition is 30 plus 40i. After rounding it up. Okay, so this is what I have. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide all these classes into different files. Alright, so my program is inside this directory called WOP, Object Oriented Programming. I'm going to create a new file. I'm going to name it complex base.h. Alright, so this is the complex base.h, and this complex base class, I'm going to cut it from my original file and then I'm going to paste it in my complex base.h. Okay, let me save this file, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to include this complex base.h. okay, but the way to do is since this is my user created file, user created header, instead of using this bracket, this what is this called, triangular shape bracket, I'm going to write double quotes, right? And inside this double quote I'm going to write complex base.h. okay, this is how I include complex base. Now let me go ahead and compile this program. Everything should be like before, and yeah, everything is like before. Okay, I have right now see the difference. This complex base class that was in my original source code is now in a different file. Okay, so let me do this with complex rectangular as well. So one new file. Complex rectangular.h. And I'm going to cut this complex rectangular from this file. Okay, and I'm going to paste it over here. All right, so far so good. Now I'm going to have some error, but I will handle the error very soon. My program.cpp is here. I'm going to create one more file. I'm going to call it complex polar.h, and I'm going to copy this complex polar class from here. Okay, and I'm going to paste it in this complex polar.h file. Okay. And now instead of complex base.h, I don't need the complex base directly in here. Instead I need complex rectangular and complex polar. Okay, so yeah, let me go ahead and try to compile this. I'm getting an error. So what are the errors? I'm getting multiple errors, in fact. So let me go through this error. one of the errors, complex base is not defined in complex rectangular. So complex rectangular does not know about complex base. So what do I have to do is I have to include complex base dot h in complex rectangular, and for the same reason I have to include complex base dot h in complex polar as well. Okay, so let me go ahead and do that, and now let me try to compile. I am trying to compile and I should get a new error. I am waiting to get the new error. So it says a few of these things are not declared in the scope. Like what is not declared? ENDL is not declared. Cout is not declared. So I am using this ENDL Cout inside print rectangular in my complex rectangular file, and I should also get that these are not declared, right? The square root and all those things are also not declared. Alright. So what I'm going to do is, since they are not declared, let me go ahead and include them. Okay. I'm going to include IO stream. I am using this C out, C in, and then this mathematical function in my complex rectangular file. So I include those libraries in my complex rectangular file. I use them in complex polar file as well. So let me go ahead and include them in complex polar as well. Okay, so this is what I have. Now I have to bring the namespace std into this file. I have to bring the namespace to this file. Okay, here the error is it is not declared in the scope, but then I have to include this. Some compiler will not include this automatically. Here files are included, but better practice is to include the file. Okay, let me go ahead and compile. Okay, now I have a new error. It says error redefinition of complex class complex base. Okay, so what is happening? When I write this line, line number 3, complex rectangular, include complex rectangular dot h. Okay, I go to complex rectangular dot h, I am including complex base dot h. Okay, and then in line number 4, I am including complex polar dot h. When I include complex polar dot h, I include complex base dot h again. So I am including complex base dot h 2 times into my main program. So that is something that is not allowed in C++. All right, I can include complex base only one time. So what do I do? I'm going to use macro. Okay, so hold on 1 second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write if not defined. Okay, complex base is some kind of a constant variable that I'm using. Okay, this is a macro, of course. Then I'm going to define complex base. Okay, and finally I'm going to end this if So here is a if condition that I am starting. Here I am ending this if condition. Okay, if not defined complex base, then I am defining complex base and I am going to execute this line number 2 to line number 16. If complex base is defined, then line number 2 to line number 16 will not be executed. Alright, so if a complex base is not defined, then execute line number 2 to 16. If defined, then do not execute. This is what if not defined means. Now let me go ahead and compile this program. Okay, now everything is being compiled properly. Okay, so what is happening? In complex rectangular, I am including complex base. Okay, when I am including this complex rectangular, at that point when I include complex base, then complex base is not defined. Okay, at that point of time, complex dot base dot h is not still included. Now when this complex base is included, this complex base will be defined. Okay, so processor will know that complex base, this part has been included into my source code. Now in line number 4, when I try to include complex base this through this complex polar dot h, when I try to include complex base again, this complex base would have been defined, right? Because I already included this complex base through complex rectangular. So when I try to include complex base through complex polar, my compiler is going to see that I have already defined this complex base class. Okay, this part is already executed. Okay, that means this class has already been included in my source file, and for that reason it is not going to be defined. Okay, so yeah, that is what I'm going to have. Okay, so writing this part, this three directive in my header file is going to prevent whatever is between these directives to be included from to be included multiple times. Alright, I do not want multiple inclusion. I want everything to be included only once. For example, this complex base class, I want it to be inserted into my code only once. If I insert this complex base class into my code multiple times, I am going to get an error. We saw that. So this is how I remove that error. Now this I am going to do with the other two classes as well. Complex rectangular, let me put it in here. If not defined complex rectangular, then I am going to define complex rectangular and I am going to execute all of this thing, and I have an end if in here. Alright, and the same thing I am going to do with complex polar. If complex polar is not defined, only then go ahead and do all this thing. Let me copy from here. This is going to be complex polar. All these terms deserve only for your processor, okay. All these things are for your processor only. These are processor directives, so that your processor is going to include these files only one time, right? Include this complex base or complex rectangular or complex polar into my source code only one time. This will prevent multiple inclusion in my file. Alright, so this is what I have. Now, let me go ahead and compile, and this is what I have. See, this IO stream, this CMAP, I have already included through complex rectangular, so I don't need to include them there. Or if I include them through main, okay, then I don't need to include them over here. All right. So let me go ahead and compile, and this is going to compile properly. Alright. Okay, so this is what I have. Now, my file is divided into different files. Alright, my entire program is divided into different files. This will allow better management of this file. Now, let me go and ahead and do one more thing. This complex polar.h, this class definition and the actual implementation of the functions, I'm going to separate them into two different files. Alright, so what I'm going to do, is I'm going to create a new file called complex polar.cpp. Okay, this is for complex polar.h. So let me copy all this. I have to make some changes that I will do later. Okay, so let me go ahead and copy all these files. Copy them here. This is what I have. I have to include INCLUDE complex polar. All right, and then the syntax is I have to write complex polar double colon, like we have been doing. Okay, so complex polar double colon, I don't need to write this keyword virtual, so let me remove all this virtual from everywhere. Right. And in front of the class function name, I have to write class name double colon. Right, this is the syntax as it was before. Means as it was in case we wrote these methods outside the class. This is how we did write methods outside the class, and that is what is going to happen here. Okay, let me write the class name double colon in front of every method name. This is what I have. Alright, so now let me save this. Okay, this is going to be problematic. I still see that I have error. Okay, so what do I do? What is the error, reason for this error? The reason is that cos is not defined. Okay, so now I have to include this cmath and iostream. Why do I have to include this iostream? Because this cout, endl, these are also not defined. So let me include all these things. And do I still have an error? I should get an error, but okay, I will wait. Now in complex polar, I have to do one thing. This definition I don't want inside my class, right? I will just have the declaration inside class. The function definition is on the other file, right? So I just have this declaration over here. This is what I have. Okay, I wrote using namespace std in this file itself, therefore I don't need to write in the other file. Okay, now let me go ahead and try to compile. Okay, I already see that I have an error. Let me do one thing. Let me comment out this complex rectangular right now. I don't need complex rectangular. Let me work with only complex polar. Okay, at this moment. So let me make it 0.33. Whatever, and this is say 10.5. Whatever be the values, okay. So this is A and B two complex polar. I see there is going to be some sort of an error. Let me go ahead and try to compile. What is the error? Okay. So it says complex polar is abstract. Okay. So when I go to this complex polar.h, that is what I included. Okay. I don't see any implementation of these files. Okay. Let me do one thing. Let me remove these keywords virtual. Okay. No reason. This is not going to change anything. This function is still going to stay virtual. Okay, there are two functions whose name I did not write. One is void print rectangular. Okay, another is void print polar. These two functions also existed in my complex polar. Okay, print rectangular and print polar. So this is my complete file. This is what I have, and when I try to execute this, let me go ahead and try to execute this, I still get an error. Okay, so it says undefined reference to complex polar double double. So apparently I cannot find this constructor. Okay, so that is the error that I have right now. So how do I remove that? The way to do that is to change how I compile. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to write do the compilation manually right now. I have two files that I want to I have this file, right? myprogram.cpp. And what is this file depending on? This depends on this complex polar.cpp. Okay, so this is what I write. G++ and then the name of these two files. Okay, I made a mistake. This is small o. And I write this enter. Okay, so this is what I end up with. My output file is this a.out. So I write a.out. Okay, and yeah, now I can compile my program. Okay, I can compile and run this program. My compilation took place without an error. This output file was generated. Let me create an output file with a different name. G++ is the name of my compiler. This is my original source file. This is the other source file that I need to be compiled. All of this will be compiled separately. Okay, the output file is say my output. Alright, this is going to be my executable file, my output. I do the compilation. My compilation took place without any error. Let me list out all the things that I have, all the files that I have in my directory. I can see my output is there in my directory. I run my output and yeah, everything is happening without any error. Alright. Now I am going to do the same thing with complex rectangular, but before I do that, I want you to look at this. This is the complex base class. This is the means complex base.h with complex base class. This is complex polar.h with complex polar class. Alright. Complex base is abstract. Alright. All of these are pure virtual function. Complex polar.h is not abstract. These are not pure virtual functions, right? These are virtual function, yes. All functions which are virtual in the parent are going to be virtual in all the descendants that are there. So these are virtual, but these are not pure virtual. I have implementation of all these functions. All these functions are implemented in this other file, complex polar.cpp. Okay, so these are all the implementation of all these functions, right? So that is one difference that you should know. Another is this private variables that I need are also declared in this class. So this file complex polar.h, I have all these attribute variables and all these methods that are there. Okay, all of these are declared in this file. These are defined in some other file. So this is one more organization of code. I can look at this complex polar.h and I will know what are the public attributes and what are the public methods that are available with this class. Okay, so I need not bother about how these methods are implemented. If I need to really check how these methods are implemented, I will go into this cpp file. Okay, complex polar.cpp. But then in order to see what are the methods available and what is the prototype, what is the signature of this method, what is this method taking as parameter, what is this method, what are all these methods returning, all these things, in order to see all these things, I simply go into this complex polar.h. Alright, and that is sufficient for me. Alright, so this is what I have. Let me do this with complex rectangular as well. Complex rectangular has all these files. Let me copy these files. Alright, and let me create a new file. Let me copy this. I have just copied all this function declaration, and I am going to copy them into this complex rectangular.cpp. I'm going to paste them. Okay, let me organize this a little bit. Of course, I use mathematical function and I use C in, C out. So I am going to include IOStream, since I use this C in and ENDL. Therefore, I am going to include IOStream, and then I am going to include CMath because I use mathematical function. And of course, I have to include my complex rectangular.h, otherwise what are all this function coming from, where is this class complex rectangular, that I am not going to know. Okay, so complex rectangular, I am going to write the name of the class and double colon. I don't need this virtual keyword, this double class name, method name, that is the syntax, return type double class name, method name, syntax. Alright, so let me do that with all these methods. I am going to write class name double colon in front of method name. This is the syntax to write methods outside the class, right? We already discussed it in our introductory far back in the very beginning of the course. Alright, so this is how I declare all these methods outside the class. So this is what I have. I have declared all these methods in this file. All these methods of complex rectangular.cpp inside this complex rectangular. All these methods of this complex rectangular class inside this complex rectangular.cpp file. Okay. Now let me remove all this declaration implementation from this class file. Okay. From this header file. Header file will only hold the declaration. All this definition will be in the cpp file. .h file will just hold what does the class look like. Okay, the actual implementation of all this function are there in this complex rectangular dot cpp file. Of course, since I am not implementing anything, I don't need to give name to these parameters. The parameters are, I just need to give the signature, okay, the prototype of this function. I don't need to actually give the name to these variables that are passed as parameter. Okay, when I implement this function, there I have to give name to these prototypes. but when I declare them, I don't need to do that. Okay, so this is what I have. This is complex rectangular dot h. The definition of this complex rectangular class, and here I have the definition. In complex rectangular dot h, I have the declaration. How does my complex rectangular class look like? In complex rectangular dot cpp, I have the actual implementation of this function, the declaration, definition of this function. Now let me go to my myprogram.cpp. Let me comment out complex polar. I am going to include complex rectangular, and instead of this complex, creating this complex polar object, I am going to create complex rectangular object. Okay. So let me not change the parameter values. Let everything be as it is. And in my compilation, I have to include complex rectangular dot cpp, right? So this is going to be my output. My compilation took place correctly. My output file is my output, and this is what I have. Yes, this is the output that is expected. A before addition, then I, this is B before addition, I add A and B, and this is what I get. All right. So yeah, this is what I have. Now I'm going to mix things up. I am going to have this as complex rectangular and this as complex polar. All right. So now I need both complex rectangular and complex polar, and I'm going to add both of these files to my during my compilation process. All right, so let me do that. Okay, I have some error. What is the error? In main. Okay, sorry, I need to include this complex polar. All right, so this is what I have. Let me go ahead. Okay, so now I'm going to get an error. I have to configure Visual Studio if I need direct compilation, but I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to use this compiler G++ directly through this terminal that you can see in the screen. Okay, now I have included complex rectangular, complex polar. Let me go ahead and compile. So compilation took place correctly, and let me print, run this program. Now executable program, and this is what I have. All right, so after execution, this is the output that I get. Okay, so fine. Now I have created two different files, I mean two different classes. Actually, I created three classes: complex base, complex rectangular, and complex polar. Okay, and complex base is an abstract class that does not have a that does not have any implementation. So there is no complex base.cpp. All right, so this is all I have in complex base. Then in complex rectangular dot h, I create the complex rectangular class. All right, so I write all the declaration, all the definition of, sorry, I write on the prototypes of all these methods. All these methods are declared over here, and in complex rectangular.cpp, I define all these methods. Right, all the implementation of all these methods are in complex rectangular.cpp. All right, similarly in complex polar.h, I have all the declaration of all these methods that are going to be there inside this complex polar file. And in complex polar.cpp, I have actually defined all these methods. Alright, and then to prevent multiple inclusion, for example, complex base.h should have been included two times in my driver file, in my myprogram.cpp, once to complex rectangular and once to complex polar. So I do not want this to be included multiple times. Therefore, I write that include complex base only if this complex base is not defined. So the first time I include this class, I'm going to define this complex base, and so when I try to include it the second time, I'm going to check this condition: is complex base defined? Yes, it was defined when I included it in the second time, first time. So in my second time, I'm not going to include this into my source code. All right, so this is what I have. And yeah, this is how you organize your code into multiple files. I have sent you all this code, right? All these separated segmented files into a zipped directory, and I sent it to you in your class group. So all these codes are inside that zip directory. Do one thing, experiment with those files, right? Try to compile those files. Make sure that you are able to compile correctly. And yeah, that is what I have. This is how you split up your program into multiple files. But the takeaway, main important thing to notice here is this thing: if not defined, then we have to define the thing. This prevents multiple inclusion. All right. This is a compiler directive. This is not part of your program. This is just telling the compiler that include this complex base.h into my main program only once. Do not include it multiple times. All right. And then go through this program, understand what is happening. So that is what is it is. All right. If you have any doubt, reach out to me. Write your doubt in the comment section below, and see you in the next video. In the next video, we are going to create another ADT. It is the list ADT.